Today we're going to align our robot using gyros. 3, 2, 1, Lego! Gyroscopes are used to determine the orientation and rate of change on aircraft and spacecraft. This is the gyro sensor on our robot. And looking at the port view, you can see that as we turn the robot, the gyro measures how many degrees we've rotated. Turning it clockwise is moving it in a positive direction, and counterclockwise is the negative direction. The number of degrees the robot turns can go beyond 360 degrees. They add up continuously. We also measure how quickly we are turning in degrees per second. This is called the rate of turning. We're going to use the information from the gyro to fine-tune the program that we wrote in the previous episode. We had to drive the robot until it hit a wall, and then we backed up and turned. When just using motor values, your turns can vary if you bump something along the way, or if the cord pulls your robot, or even if your batteries are a little bit lower. Using a gyro, we are more likely to have a repetitive process. We can tell the robot to back up until it has turned 90 degrees. Again, we can use a loop to accomplish this. When we pick an exit for the loop, we're going to use the gyro sensor. We can either look for the angle or the rate. And this time we're going to use the angle that the robot has turned. The default port for the gyro is 2, so we should leave this value alone. We know that we want the robot to exit the loop when it hits 90 degrees, so we're going to put 90 degrees into this field. Let's play this next part in slow motion to see what values the robot is reading. We notice two things. The gyro has gone past 90 degrees after hitting the first wall, and it can't find 90 degrees after hitting the second wall. Remember in a previous episode, we turned the motor power down for the robot to be able to ask the encoder how far we had gone? Again, we're going to turn the motor power down to make a more controlled turn. We also need to reset the value of the gyro after it turns. Go down to the yellow sensor tab and pick the gyro sensor block. Leave the port 2 at the top the same. And now you have three options. You can measure, compare, or reset the gyro value. We want to reset it so it hits 0 after we have turned. This program turns a lot smoother, but it also means we always turn right. So how do you think we could change the code to make it go left or switch between going left and right? If you have any questions or comments, let us know down below. You can also talk to us on Twitter, Tumblr, Reddit, Instagram, or Facebook. And remember, keep exploring.